Hey everybody, how you doing? Today I'm going to show you how to install an Xfinity thermostat to your Xfinity home system. Things you might need for this installation include a precision toolkit like this. This one is by Radio Shack. I'll leave a link in the description to where you, Amazon link that you can buy one of these, because you're going to need the little small fine head to install the little wires that are in your wall. All right, so you keep here in mind that you're gonna need this. You might also need a drill, anchor screws. If you don't know how to use anchor screws, follow the link right here in the corner, and that's a tutorial that I made, on how to use anchor screws. So let's get into it. All right, everybody. So in order for you to pair a thermostat to your system, you have to first make sure that the thermostat is defaulted. If you bought a brand new one, it should be defaulted. But if you're like me and you want to save some money and you bought it on eBay or you bought it on a website like Amazon used or something like that, I'm going to show you how to default this so that it's not installed with any system. All right, so first thing you're going to want to do is pull on this, put your thumb right here on the, like right above the screen, hold this, and then just pull this up and back and see, it just comes off easily. All right, so what you're gonna wanna do is, while pressing the hold button, press and release the black reset button. All right, so while pressing this, press and release this while keep on holding this, and then when the temperature appears, you release the hold button. So I'm gonna press and hold this, press that. When the temperature appears, I'm going to release. All right, so we should be in pairing mode right now. So let's go and try to install this. I'm gonna put in my code right here. I'm gonna go to home devices, thermostat, add thermostat. It's flashing, that means it's in pairing mode. Now it's preparing to locate thermostat. I forgot that step right there. I think I have to do that over again because I waited too long, but it's okay. So hold, press and release. Okay, here we go. Hold, press and release. It appeared. There it is, pairing. See? Perfect. It's awesome. It says it's pairing, which is a good sign. Let it do its thing, it's talking. Nowhere on the internet can you find this, folks. I even called Xfinity and they had no instructions on this. But actually they had some instructions on the website on how to reset this thing, but the agent on the phone couldn't figure it out. So I decided that you guys should see, it says thermostat right there. So now it's added to the system. Press done. And a total of one thermostat device has been located and paired. Click next to configure them. Next. And press the thermostat icon to configure it. So I'm gonna press this, and right now I'm gonna rename the thermostat. I'm gonna call it Allan House Heat. Allan's House Heat Thermostat. No, that's fine, Allan's House Heat. Done, okay, next. And so now we're ready to go downstairs and put it on the wall. All right, everyone, I have my old thermostat removed. I had a Honeywell, and this is the new Xfinity thermostat that we just mounted. I mean, we just added to our Xfinity home system. So now we can actually control it from the app. Actually, now we can't. After we hooked up to these wires, you can. Precaution that you wanna take. If you have an HVAC system, which I don't, you're gonna wanna go to your house power and turn your HVAC system off. I'm not a professional by any ways, by any means necessary. I'm not a professional, but I'm just gonna show you how to do this. yourself so you can save a bunch of money and don't have to call a technician out, as I usually do in my tutorials. So if you have an HVAC system, which I don't, make sure you go to downstairs to your power box and turn that HVAC system off before you do this. So you're gonna wanna take apart your old thermostat, take your old thermostat off the wall, and then unhook the cables with your precision screwdriver. But one important thing you wanna do is you wanna make sure that you secure these lines so that they don't fall inside of the wall, because if they fall inside of the wall, that's not gonna be a good day, guys. All right, guys, if your system is simple like mine, just adjusting the thing here, let's bring some light over here. If your system is simple like mine, then you're gonna follow these instructions, okay? If not, then I'm gonna list some instructions for you at the bottom. But basically, if you have more wires than me, I'm gonna list those wires at the bottom of the screen. And where you should plug them in. If not, then just follow my lead if you have the same setup like me. Me and you only have three simple wires. I have old radiator style heating. So it's basically gonna go green to green, white to WI, and the yellow goes to RC. All right, so let's hook this up. The first one that's sticking in there, white to the WI. So I just stick that in there and I use this to get in there and twist. Just twist it and it locks it into place. All right, put the green inside, twist it, locks it into place, and the yellow to the RC. Now, if you have an HVAC system, you have to make sure that this little jumper thing, I don't know if you can see that, but there's a little jumper thing that goes from double RC to RH. If you have an HVAC system, you gotta make sure that jumper is in there so that it connects kind of RC to RH. All right, so that should come actually in your system already. And as you can see, give this a little tug, make sure they're in there. So now I can make sure I can release this and it won't fall inside of the wall. It's just hanging there. All right. Woo! Almost there, guys. All right, so now I previously installed my screws, my drywall screws. If you want to know how to do that, like I said, watch my drywall, my how to use anchor screw tutorial. Basically, what I do is I would just put this up on the wall like this. Make sure it's flush, right? Using a leveler if you have one, or you could just eyeball it, and then take a pencil, make four little marks in there. 1, 2, 3, 4 at the bottom. Let me zoom out a little bit so you guys can see. Yeah, make 1, 2, 3, 4. Take it off. Make your drills. Make your drills with the appropriate size drill bit. And then push your anchor screws inside. That's basically how to do it without watching my tutorial. But watch my tutorial. Okay, so the next step you're gonna do is get your screws. Get your screws. I'm gonna show you guys how to do the whole thing. I don't skip in my tutorial. Some people just show you how to do one thing. I wanna show you how to do the whole entire thing. So I'm gonna get my screws. You can fast forward past this part if you want to, straight to the part where I show you how it works. In the Xfinity home app, because that's what I'm gonna show you next. I'm gonna go on my Xfinity app and see if this number changes when I change it, just to make sure it works. Oh gosh. All right, here we go. So I'm in my Xfinity Home app. See the heat's on 72 right now. I don't know if that's accurate, but I'm gonna scroll down. I'm gonna tap right here. It says it's off, so I'm gonna turn it on. Temperature hold on. Holding on. Okay, let me turn this off. Hold off. Wait a minute. All right, so let's see. You're gonna go to heat. And we're gonna go up. See how long it takes this thing to work. I just heard a click. There you go. You heard, I don't know if you guys heard the system cut on, but I heard it, and you guys see the flame came on the screen. So now we know that we're definitely synced up and we can operate our heat straight from our phone. So you're driving home from work, you want to get home to a nice toasty house, you turn the heat up right here from your app. And let's take it a step further. Let me show you guys the app on the phone. I mean on the computer.
All right, so connecting to the home. Okay, so now we are at, we click on thermostat. All right, we see the manage schedule. Click on manage schedule right here. And look at this. This is the schedule for your the days of the week. So you can click on Monday and you can see what we have it set up. You can click if you like that and you want to do it all week, apply to all week. You see it just applied it to all week. If you want to change Tuesday, right? Wait a minute, you want to change Tuesday and apply to all days, apply all week. No. Yeah, you can change that. You can slide that like this. So around 6:15, you want the heat to go up. You want the heat to go up. Just double click on that and press up. Around that time that day, and around this time, you know, okay, I'm gonna be going to work or something like that. So you want the heat to go down, you know what I mean? Stuff like that. So you can pretty much program your heat for the whole week. And how awesome is this? This is the greatest, easiest way to make controlling your heat so user-friendly and easy. And look, here's the name I put in my system right there, Allan. House heat.
So yeah, guys, thank you for joining me and watching this tutorial. I wonder if any of you guys was excited as I was when I found that last feature that you can program your whole week out with the app on a computer. It's pretty dope. But yeah, if you like this video and if it was helpful for you, then make sure you share it with one of your friends so they can save some money on their heating bills, on their cooling bills and things like that with the Xfinity home system. I'm not sponsored by Xfinity or anything, but I just really like the technology and I think that they can make it a lot simpler by simpler by a lot of the stuff we can do ourselves. But this is like awesome being able to hook this up yourself, and you saw everything works, everything's great. So yeah, if you found this helpful, then leave a comment. If you have any questions, give the video a thumbs up, and don't forget to please subscribe to my channel. All right, talk to you later. Peace.